This is the story of two women speed skaters and their quest for Olympic greatness. One is 27-year-old Karin Kania of the German Democratic Republic. She lives in Dresden with her husband and small son. Leading to the Calgary Games, Karin Kania was already a legend, the winner of 3 gold and 2 silver medals in 2 previous Olympic Games. The other is 24-year-old Yvonne von Gennip of the Netherlands. 4 years earlier in Sarajevo, she competed in 2 long-distance events, but did not win a medal. Both her events were won by East Germans. Today, Yvonne von Gennip is the main challenger to Karin Kania and her teammates. Karin Kania won her first gold medal at the 1980 Lake Placid Games. 4 years later in Sarajevo, she was the outstanding speed skater, winning 2 gold and 2 silver medals in the 4 events. Here in Calgary, she is again expected to win a medal in every event she enters.
Before the Games, people thought that I could win as many medals as I did in Sarajevo. That was, of course, a possibility. I would be satisfied to win gold medals in my specialties, the 1,000 and 1,500 meters. It would be nice, for I am the defending Olympic champion in both those events.
Yvonne von Gennip is entered in the 3 middle and long distance events, the 1,500, 3,000, and 5,000 meters. But her physical condition is suspect. Less than 3 months before the Calgary Games, she injured her foot during an international competition.
I had to go back for a surgery. I think that was the best thing I could have, because everyone expected too much from me. And after the operation, nobody did it. And for me, it was good.
Karin Kania is the leader of the most awesome group of speed skaters to ever come from a single country. Women who have dominated the sport for almost a decade. Joining Karin Kania in Calgary are 2 defending champions from the 1984 Sarajevo Games. Krista Rottenberger, the 500 meter gold medal winner. And Andrea Eric, the 3000 meter champion, who like Karin Kania, is capable of winning medals at all 5 distances. Kania, Rottenberger, and Eric all belong to the same skate club in Dresden. Incredibly, they were responsible for winning every gold and silver medal in Sarajevo. Monday, February 22nd, the 500 meter final, the first event on the women's program. 30 women are entered, but only 3 are given a chance at the gold medal. Defending Olympic champion, Krista Rottenberger of the German Democratic Republic. Karin Kania, who in the previous Olympics has won a gold and silver medal in this event. And Bonnie Blair of the United States, whose world record was broken by Rottenberger 2 months earlier. These 3 are the only women to ever skate the distance under 40 seconds. Yvonne von Gennip is not in the race, but she will observe the East German she will be facing later. Though there are 15 heats, the winner will most likely be decided early. All 3 favorites will skate before the 6th heat. Krista Rottenberger breaks her own world record in the 2nd heat and goes into the lead. Bonnie Blair of the United States is in the 4th heat. The skaters will travel 100 meters to the finish line, then once more around the 400 meter course. Blair reaches the 100 meter checkpoint, 2/100ths of a second faster than Rottenberger.
100 meters, 10.55 seconds. That's the fastest time of even this
sport. 4 years ago in Sarajevo, when she was 19, Bonnie Blair finished 8th behind Rottenberger and Kania in this event. Blair looks to the scoreboard. She breaks Rottenberger's world record by 2/100ths of a second and is in first place. Now the 5th heat. Karin Kania is opposed by Christine Oftink of the Netherlands. Karin Kania began her career as a figure skater, but she grew too tall and switched to speed skating. She is 5'9" tall. At 100 meters, Kania is a fifth of a second behind Bonnie Blair's time.
In speed skating, there is not an ideal size. The most important part of speed skating is whether one can effectively use one's stride in proper relationship with your height, strength and weight.
Coming off the final turn, Kania is making up some of the time. But it is not enough. Bonnie Blair of the United States first. Christa Rothenberger, East Germany second. Karin Kania, East Germany third. Only 1/14 of a second separates first and third place. One of the first to congratulate the American champion is Yvonne von Hennep. She tells her, "You showed us it is possible for the East Germans to be beaten." The next evening, the final of the 3,000 meters, 7.5 times around the 400-meter oval. Until the 5,000 meters was added here in Calgary, it was the longest event on the women's program. 4 years earlier in Sarajevo, Yvonne von Hennep finished fifth in the 3,000 meters. Standing on the victory podium that night were the three East Germans she would have to face again this evening. Andrea Erich, the gold medal winner. Karin Kania, the silver medal. The competition will begin in exactly five and Gabi Zanga, the winner of the bronze. Bonnie Blair's victory in the 500 meters has become a psychological boost for Yvonne von Hennep.
I didn't look up at the East Germans anymore. Before, I always thought they were stronger, they were bigger. You must not think that they are better and faster. You have to think you are good too. The
first pair of skaters. By the luck of the draw, the two great East German skaters, Karin Kania and Andrea Erich, are paired in the first heat. For many, the gold medal could be decided in the very first race. At the start, Karin Kania is on the outside wearing the red armband.
Skating first has both advantages and disadvantages. If he skated fast enough to create a world record, it would certainly affect psychologically those who followed. This is an advantage. However, by skating first, and of course not knowing how the others will do, there is danger of going too fast. By the end of the second lap, I felt we were going too fast.
At designated points, the skaters switch lanes to compensate for the longer distance of the outside lane. The 400 meters is measured from the inside lane of the oval. Lap by lap goes by. They are on a world record pace.
I had a slight cold and cough. With 2.5 laps to go, I had difficulty breathing and was very tired. Though I was leading Andrea, I was totally exhausted. With 400 meters to go, I fell far behind her. There was no feeling in my legs, and I lost my form and rhythm.
Andrea Erich has not been affected by the devastating pace. Karin Kania falls farther and farther behind. At the finish, Andrea Erich has broken the world record by an incredible 4 seconds. Almost 7 seconds behind her, Karin Kania. This is Andrea Erich's fourth Olympic Games. Her time is so spectacular, it appears certain she has successfully defended her Olympic championship, even though it is only the first heat.
0.09 seconds, a new world record.
Andrea Erich skates towards Karin Kania, who has collapsed at the side of the track. For Karin Kania, the next hour would be the most frightening of her life.
I could not move. I had trouble breathing. I did not think I would be able to ever get up. It was decided that it would be best for me to stay where I was.
The competition goes on. In the third heat, Gabi Zanga of East Germany moves past Kania into second place. Yvonne von Gennip gets ready for her race in the fourth heat. As in Sarajevo, the East Germans are again in first, second, and third.
Ladies and gentlemen, fire to the start, please.
For Yvonne von Gennip, the road to Calgary has been unique. Besides having to recover from surgery, her personal coach of 4 years, Chad Klosterboer, is not here. The Dutch team will be supervised by the head coach, Egbert van Tuve. But von Gennip will almost daily be in telephone conversation with Chad Klosterboer.
We decided very early that I should not go to Calgary. It was not good that there were two trainers in Calgary. That could give much commotion, and it was better for Yvonne to concentrate for herself.
I trained with him for 4 years. I had a scheme, and I was used to do it in that way. So I only phoned when I was a little bit doubting. But I had Egbert too, so I think the combination was quite well.
She is strong. She has a very good technique. She has all the things you need to be the best.
With one lap to go, Yvonne von Gennip is almost a full second behind Andrea Erich of East Germany.
I heard people screaming. I only thought you have to skate hard and fast.
Coming down the home stretch, Yvonne von Gennip has made up much of the deficit. Yvonne von Gennip breaks Erich's record by 1/15 of a second and wins the 3,000-meter gold medal. Karin Kania is helped from the arena. It is now questionable whether she will continue to compete. Three days later, the final of the 1,000 meters. The break in the schedule has been a benefit to Karin Kania. Though she still has a cough and sore throat, she has recovered from her collapse. The 1,000 meters is one of Kania's favorite races. 2.5 times around the oval. She is world record holder and defending Olympic champion. Her main opposition will again come from Krista Rothenberger and Bonnie Blair. Yvonne von Gennip is not in the race. Bonnie Blair breaks the Olympic record in heat 3 and goes into the lead. She signals the cheering crowd to quiet. Karin Kania is ready to skate against her teammate, Angela Stanka. Karin Kania, on the outside again, wears the red armband.
I knew almost immediately that this would be a good race. The ice was very fast and I was experiencing no trouble breathing. Though I had a sore throat, it was not a handicap since the race takes only a little over 1 minute.
Kania betters her own world record and moves into first place.
7 seconds. She breaks her own world record.
The only remaining skater with the ability to challenge me was my friend and teammate Krista Rothenberger. Since I had broken my world record and Krista's best time was more than a second slower than that, it seemed unlikely she would improve based on her times leading to Calgary.
Krista Rothenberger's partner in the fifth heat is Seiko Hashimoto, the same skater who was paired with her in the 500 meters. There is added drama in the race. A coach for the German Democratic Republic team is Ernst Luding. Though he is overjoyed at Kania's magnificent performance, he has a personal interest in the performance of Krista Rothenberger. Luding and Rothenberger are engaged and will marry after the games.
As I was cooling down, I heard Krista's split time and it was difficult to believe. She was going at a faster pace than I had. With one lap to go, 400 meters, she was more than half a second faster. I knew she would have to slow down. The question was, by how much?
Rottenberger comes off the final turn. She is slowing down, but infinitesimally. Kania looks at the scoreboard. She knows she has lost the gold medal by 0.05 seconds. Coach Ernst Luding of the East German team greets his fiance. The victory platform ceremony takes place. The same three women who stood there earlier in the week in the 500 meters are there again. But they are standing on different steps. Rottenberger first. Kania second. Blair third.
I was happy for Krista, but to lose by such a small margin, especially when I was sure of the victory, was very disappointing. Throughout my career, I have beaten many skaters by such a margin, and it is ironic that I should be beaten like that at the Olympic Games. This race will remain with me for a long time. I will live over many times on which of the turns I could have been more technically correct. Those 0.05 seconds were the difference between the gold and the silver medal.
Saturday, February 27th, the 1500 meter final. Karin Kania is the defending Olympic champion from the Sarajevo Games 4 years earlier. Also in the race, her teammate Andrea Eric, who won the silver medal. Their main opposition, Yvonne van Gennip of the Netherlands.
Yvonne called me after the 3000 meters to tell about the race and to discuss about the next race on 1500 meters 2 days later. That was the power of Yvonne, that she could get that concentration back and to go for the next days in the same way she did for the 3000 meters.
The skaters will travel 3¾ times around the 400 meter oval. Again, Yvonne van Gennip will skate after her two East German rivals, as she did in the 3000 meters 4 days earlier. Andrea Eric sets an Olympic record in heat 2, almost 2 seconds faster than Karin Kania's time when she won the gold in Sarajevo. It is now Karin Kania's turn in heat 4. She will be skating against Yvonne van Gennip's teammate, Marike Stem.
I felt very good. Although I was still having problems with the air, it was no concern during the race. I did not believe that Andrea's time would be good enough to win the gold medal. Another interesting thing occurred. I was getting a little superstitious. Again, just like in the 3000 meters, Andrea and I would skate before Yvonne. And I thought, is this some sort of omen that Yvonne always skates after us?
Karin Kania takes the final turn. She crosses the finish line more than a half second better than her teammate. Now it is time for Yvonne van Gennip. She will skate against Gunda Kleymann of East Germany.
There is a will of winning in her. She wants to win. She wants to be the first. We have always been in the second places for the last years, and the focus was totally on the East German girls. They should win everything, and for Yvonne, there should only be third or fourth places.
The press looked at Karin, and now they were looking a little bit at me. The East Germans were expected to do well and to win the first place, and nobody expected it from me.
I watched Yvonne's race. After 700 meters, she was still 0.2 seconds behind my time. But that means nothing. There were still 2 laps to go. At this point, I was not confident especially since she won the 3,000 meters a few days earlier with an amazing last lap time.
The lap times are being given to Von Hennep by head coach Egbert von Tuber. Von Hennep responds and skates a tremendous third lap. With one lap to go, she moves ahead of Kania by almost a half second. She has defeated Karin Kania by 14 hundredths of a second. Von Hennep has won her second gold medal. The victory platform ceremony takes place. Yvonne von Hennep stands on the top step for the second time. On either side of her, Karin Kania and Andrea Erich of East Germany.
It was a very emotional moment for me. I had decided that this would be my final race. I would not skate in the 5,000 meters the next day. Standing there, it was difficult to believe it all did not turn out as I had hoped. My ambition was to win two gold medals, but it was not to be. It is very good for the sport that others come along and are able to do what we did. I'm so happy for Yvonne. She's a peaceful person, quiet, modest.
Karin Kania's Olympic career is now over. Though she was dethroned as champion in two Olympic races, she created Olympic history as the greatest speed skating medalist ever, a winner of three gold, four silver, and one bronze medal. Sunday afternoon, February 28th, the final women's speed skating event on the final day of the Calgary Olympic Games. Even though Andrea Erich sets a world record, skating in the first heat against Ingrid Paul of the Netherlands, it is believed that this record will not stand for long. For in the fifth heat, Yvonne von Hennep will step to the starting line. Her partner, Elena Lapuga of the Soviet Union.
Skating, you need some imagination. After 4 minutes and 5,000 meters, you have to think about the nice things for your concentration and self-consciousness. But I felt myself the strongest in the 5,000. And people said before that I had more chance in the 5,000 than the other races.
With a few hundred meters to go in the race, Yvonne von Hennep is almost 3 seconds faster than Andrea Erich's newly set world record. Yvonne von Hennep wins her third gold medal. After the games, Yvonne returns home to a hero's welcome. There she is reunited with her personal coach, Chad Klosterboer. But for Yvonne von Hennep, life for her, is not alone winning at the Olympic Games.
I think you need goals in life. Everybody has a goal. But it doesn't mean that a goal must be a very high goal. I took the decision that winning medals is not important. You are important for your person, your character.